In IBM, a clueless biologist like me got wonderful opportunities to dream big. An example of that is how, you know, I got involved in the very early stages of Blue Gene as a supercomputer, even before it was built, and thinking, well, what would we use it for in biology? And so we spent actually a few years building a research team, developing the methodologies for simulating proteins on supercomputers like Blue Gene before Blue Gene was built. A second project in IBM that I got involved in, it's the Genographic Project. At the outset, it seemed like such a strange thing for IBM to get involved in. We, IBM, are actually going to go gather human DNA samples from across the whole planet, use that to infer human ancestry. But how do we make it relevant to IBM? And one of the senior leaders in IBM actually turned that around and pointed it out to us that this is innovation that matters. This is how we take our science and make it relevant to ourselves and to the whole world. We taught ourselves how to analyze genetically diverse information from across the whole population. An extension of this work continues actually into looking at genetic basis of a number of diseases. Take cancer as an example. Cancer is a disease of the genome. It's a genome of some cells in your body that begins to misbehave. So understanding the genetic changes in the cell and then using that information or the variation between the normal and the cancer genome as the basis to then interpret the biology of the cancer and the biology of what drugs would be appropriate for the variations that you're seeing in this cancer. All of that is downstream of this original thinking. A lot has happened in this field since then. We built a team both here in research division and in now the Watson Health business unit. We came together in the last 3 years, we've actually built this engine. So it's gone from just being a science to actually something that practitioners now have access to and can use that in informing their decisions that are patient facing. Looking back through the years that I've been fortunate to spend in IBM, I find it remarkable that a biologist who didn't even know that he belongs in IBM to begin with, first is allowed to wander into this company. Is allowed to think, is allowed to think big. And I returned to my roots as a biologist and I said, how can a biologist be this lucky?